Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So let's continue with our topic, lathe machine. In last video, we have studied about headstock assembly and carriage assembly with the construction of chuck and carriage. All these video links are in description box. Today, we will study about tailstock assembly and lathe accessories. So let's begin. Tailstock is located on right side of the bed, that is right hand side of the operation. The main purpose of tailstock on an engine lathe is to support free end of a work during operations. It is also used to hold tools for making holes adjusted along the bed of lathe accommodate different length of the stock. It is provided with set over screw at its base for taper turning alignment. It has cast iron body with bore to accommodate tailstock spindle, and the top portion contains the spindle, tailstock hand wheel and a spindle clamp for locking the spindle in the position. The end of the spindle has a taper bore for holding dead center, taper shank drills and other tools. The non-rotating tailstock spindle has a tapered hole that can be fitted with tooling such as live or dead centers, drilling chuck or tapered tools. The spindle can be extended or retarded with hand wheel or locked in place with tailstock spindle lock. The tailstock spindle is typically graduated for rough positioning. Tailstock hand wheel is used to extend or retard the tailstock spindle. The lathe machines are provided with different accessories. The lathe accessories are used for holding and supporting the work and holding the tool. The following lathe accessories are employed on the lathe: center, angle plate, driving plate, face plate, mandrels, rest. Let's study all these accessories in detail. Lathe center. The lathe center are used for supporting the work during turning operation. The work is held between the live center and dead center. The figure shown here consists of headstock, workpiece, tailstock sleeve, live center, tool and the dead center. So what is live center and dead center? The center which is fitted in the headstock spindle is called as live center, and the center which is fitted in tailstock is called as dead center. It supports the other end of the work but does not revolve with it. These centers are made up of hardened steel. They have taper shanks of 0 to 6 more standard tapers. Common types of lathe centers are ordinary centers. This type of center is used for most general work. Insert type center. This is more expensive type of center. It consists of hard alloy tip braced into the ordinary steel shank It is highly resistant to wear and strain. Pipe center. The pipe center are used for supporting the open ends of pipe, turns, shells, etc. for thread cutting operation or turning in the lathe. Half center. It is similar to the ordinary center. Only half cone of center is grounded. It is useful in facing operation. Ball center. It is used to minimize wear and strain on lathe. Revolving center. It is also known as frictionless center. It is always used in tailstock for supporting heavy work revolving at high speed. In this type of center, even an ordinary center freely revolves in call and roll bearing, which reduces the friction. Faceplate. It is a cast iron circular disc having a threaded hole at its center so that it can be screwed on the threaded nose of spindle. There are number of holes and slots provided on these plate. It is used for holding the work which cannot be held between center or on the chuck. The work is held with the help of clamping plate and bolt. Lathe dock and driving plate. Here the figure shows the location of lathe dock and driving plate. Driving plate is also known as catch plate. A driving plate or a catch plate is a disc made up of cast iron or steel. It has a central boss and catch pin projecting from it. It is screwed on threaded nose of headstock spindle. It is used for driving the work with the help of projecting pin on it, with the dog or carrier clamp to work while turning the work between the centers. Lathe dog are used with driving plate to drive the workpiece held between centers. Work is clamped on lathe dock by means of set screw. The next lathe accessory is angle plate. Angle plate is made by machining two plates at 90 degree. Since the plates are joined at a particular angle, so it is named as angle plate. An angle plate is L-shaped cast iron plate. Two faces of the plate are at right angle and having the slot of clamping face plate on its surface. It is used for holding the work which is not possible to mount directly on the face plate. The next lathe accessories is mandrel. Mandrel is a device used for holding and rotating a workpiece that has been previously drilled or bored. It is a solid shaft made up of high carbon steel. It is mounted between centers and work revolves with it. It is driven by driving plate and lathe dog. The different types of mandrels are plain mandrel. The body of plain mandrel is slightly tapered. This taper is provided for proper gripping of workpiece. It is mostly used for standard size work and repetition jobs. Every workpiece of different internal diameter requires separate mandrels. The next type of mandrel is collar mandrel. It is used for holding large diameter workpiece. The diameter of about 100 millimeters and above is held by collar provided on mandrel. Collar type construction reduces the weight as compared with plain mandrel for same size workpiece. For different size workpiece, different mandrels are required. The next type is expansion mandrel. It is used to reduce number of mandrels required for holding different diameter work. Common type of expansion mandrel consists of a split sleeve which is mounted on a inner mandrel. This sleeve is tapered and parallel outside. The work is mounted on sleeve which expand within the certain limits when inner mandrel is pushed through it. This type of mandrel is used for holes of odd size. The last type of mandrel is cone mandrel. A cone mandrel consists of fixed type of cone and sliding cone which can be adjusted by means of nut provided on the threaded end. It is used for holding higher diameter holes of various dimensions. The next type of lathe accessories is lathe rest. Rest is a device which is used to support long cylinder job at an intermediate point to prevent it from bending due to its own weight and vibration caused by cutting force acting on it. Rest would be used when length of workpiece is more than 12 times its diameter. Some common types of rest are steady rest and follower rest. Steady rest. It is also known as center rest. This rest remains stationary at one position with respect to tools. It consists of cast iron frame and three adjustable jaws. The frame is made up of two parts which are hinged at one end to give facility of ease setting and removing of workpiece. The bottom portion of rest has grooves corresponding to the lathe bed away and can slide on it. Rest can be clamped at any desired position where support is required. All the three jaws can be adjusted radially by using set screw to accommodate the job of any diameter. Steady rest can also be used to support the free end of job in drilling, rimming, etc. Follower rest. It is also known as traveling rest. This rest moves along with the tool during the turning operations. It consists of a frame with two adjustable jaws. The jaws can be adjusted to support work between them and turning tool. The frame is attached to the saddle of carriage and travel longitudinal along with the tool to give continuous support to the workpiece. It is used to support flexible jaws to prevent them from the springing away during turning operations.
So guys, that's all for today. For more such videos, please like, share and subscribe to our channel.